Motor City, Detroit City.
What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Skin Gang, back with another review. Trying to get this one in kind of quickly because I'm not supposed to be doing this. I had to sneak to do this review for you guys. So this particular shoe, this is obviously the Aeris 11s that came out today, actually. All the stores in my area were doing raffles for them on Tuesday and Wednesday, so the 13th and 14th. And I knew that I wasn't going to be able to do any raffles because I was actually in the hospital for a procedure on Wednesday. I just got out on Friday, which is why I had to sneak to do this review because my husband wants me to be resting. But I'm home. Everything is good. Thank you in advance for your well wishes. But since I knew I wasn't going to be able to do any raffles for him and I really, really wanted this shoe, I pre-ordered it with the plug. And I paid to have him ship early. So they actually got here yesterday when I got home from the hospital. So that was a nice welcome home gift. So let's get into it. I've already taken them out of the box, but the official name and colorway on these are the Air Jordan 11 Retro RLGG, as in Girls Grade School. I don't know what the RL stands for, so if you know, let me know. Official colorway is Night Maroon and Metallic Gold, and I got these in a 5Y. These retail for $220. Shout out to my homie Gone AWOL. You right, because that price bump is another level, but these shoes were worth it, so I got to give you that. These are dope. So here they go. Man, take a look. Okay. So your outsole is this like maroon color, kind of like a gummy maroon color. You can kind of see it kind of translucent a little bit. You still see barely, you can barely see your Jumpman there in the bottom on the outsole and your pods. It's all maroon with the white in the midsole area. And then when you get up here to the upper, you have where it's traditionally on 11s, where this would traditionally be patent leather, this is the velvet, red velvet. And then up here is this nice, like, suede. Like, these are some nice materials, y'all. On the laces, we actually got the gold, metallic gold lace tips, which are still plastic, but it's a nice touch. They have the metallic-y sound. On the back, your 2-3. Is actually stitched in. Okay. This whole upper, like all of this is like suede. It's so nice. It feels just amazing. Your Jumpman on the side is actually like metallic as well. And attached to the side here. The insoles of the shoe are leather. And it says Jordan Fine Footwear since 1985. There you go. And it's maroon as well. Really nice. Like I said, I knew that I wanted these, so I went ahead and paid a premium to have them come here. I'm gonna be honest with you. So in the very beginning, the first pairs that we saw, the first like pictures of these looked terrible. So they were clearly like the fakes. And they, like, this whole upper looked like some plastically fake leather. It looked trashy. And then this velvet looked like real, like a bright red. And so I was kind of like, no, I'm not really feeling them. But when I saw actually the retail pairs and what they look like, wow. I mean, wow. This shoe is just amazing. It's just amazing. And also for comparison's sake, I didn't do this in my other review, but for the Space Jam. So when we talk about like the quality of the Space Jams and things like that, these also have similar quality in that the Space Jams had the 45 stitched in the back. And here we have the 23 stitched in the back. Okay. So yeah, I'm very happy, to have these. I'm going to let you guys see them on feet, but I just want to kind of give a quick review to all my subscribers so you guys can see what they look like. If you were able to cop a pair or not, hopefully you were. We still have the same thing on the tongue, the quality basketball products inspired by the greatest player ever. There you go. Your size tag and everything like that is on the inside of the shoe. These are just lovely. My husband was like, you see what it looks like on the inside of the stamp. And my husband's like, where are you going to wear these? Like, when do you wear them? You going to wear them in the snow? I'm like, no. You going to wear them in the mud? No, but these will get worn. You know, I'm hoping to be fully healed and recovered by Christmas. So this might be part of my Christmas outfit with a nice ugly sweater that I can rock. But dope shoe. Dope shoe. Nice interior. The sock liner is nice. Nice and plush. It's a great shoe, man. It's a great shoe. I'm going to let you guys see these on feet. So I was actually, again, the reason why I pre-ordered the pair with the plug was because I was afraid that I wasn't going to be able to get them, maybe not home already from the hospital or whatever, but I was. And so I was also able to get a pair online at Nike.com today. So that pair is going to be coming in. So if anybody needs a 5Y, let me know. I will probably try to split the cost with you since I've already had to pay for them, but whatever. You got your carbon fiber. The carbon fiber is also in maroon color. It's nice. Here they are together. Dope shoe, y'all. Let me know if you were able to cop. Let me know if you intentionally passed. I know a lot of people were upset. I saw a few rants on IG, you know, pissed off that they couldn't get these shoes after with all the resellers and everything like that killing the game. And I understand that. I do, because I have my times of frustration. I just figure that at some point you either gotta, you know, give in and say, okay, it's something I want so bad that I'm willing to give in to the resellers, or you wait it out and you say, maybe I'm gonna get lucky. I know a lot of people just got lucky, you know, with the Foot Locker apps and stuff like that. People were able to cop pairs, and it wasn't as hard as I thought either. I assumed that with the $220 price tag that it would actually be okay and not that hard to cop, because with the Space Jams just coming out and people getting those for their kids and a lot of grade school sizes getting them, I figured with the $220 price tag, it would make these easier to cop, but apparently they still sold out pretty quickly. So I get it. I understand. But like I said, I do have an extra 5Y. It might just be going back to Nike if nobody wants it. Again, I'm not in it to make a profit, but you let me know if you're interested. And I'm going to let y'all see these on feet. I was also able to cop the DB7s, so those should be coming in next week. And so when I get them, y'all get a review for those. And otherwise, stay tuned for this on feet.